Welcome to Taft, California. Incredibly hot, Taft.
Incredibly hot. It's 3:30 in the afternoon.
And as you can see, we're going
skydiving.
We're
going skydiving.
Woo! We're here celebrating our big 25.
25 years.
Yep, and we're doing it to celebrate our birthday together because there's no better way to do something like this than together. It is actually 100
exactly
degrees.
100 degrees.
Who's excited?
I am.
We're so excited to bring you on this adventure with us. We're going to bring you on every step of the way as per usual. So come along, let's go do it!
Welcome to Skydive Town!
Woo! So excited!
First timers?
Yes.
How the nerves?
Horrible.
Horrible.
Clearly horrible. I'm so nervous. Now I'm so excited!
And what's your name?
Marissa.
Marissa.
Austin. We're the Wanderers.
We're going to go to the
Wanderers. We are the Wanderers.
Well, let's wander our way up to 13,000 feet and huck ourselves out of an airplane.
Woo! Hell yeah! For you, Dad.
All right. High five.
For my dad as well.
Mwah!
Top Gun, look at that nice jumpsuit.
Yeah.
We're gonna fly like a bird in the sky. I might even cry. Let's do this.
Let's go.
Woo! Let's do it! Oh my God, look at this plane! Woo!
Real now.
N39er 8A, let's do it.
Right on.
Woo! Let's go, Dan!
Let's go, me!
Dan the man! Woo!
Right, watch your head. Keep your head low.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Felicia.
Bye.
Woo! Oh my gosh, we just did it! Woo!
What was your favorite part?
You, Dan.
Me?
Dan, thank you. I'm serious. Thank you so much.
Thank you for the skydive. You gonna do it again?
Yes.
Yeah.
Me and my suit. Let's go again.
All right, again.
Thank you, Dan.
You're welcome. Thank you. Well, tell me.
Oh my God.
You just jumped from 13,000 feet, which fun we flew.
13,000 feet.
Would you do it again?
Absolutely.
Well, high five, you can do this. You can do anything. Thank you for coming to Skydive Taft. Boom.
Hello, everybody. I'm Austin, half of Where the Wanderers. This is my incredible instructor, Bevo, who took incredible care of me. I was so incredibly nervous, but he helped calm me down, he helped keep me centered, and we made it down alive. And I'm so thankful for that. First question for you is, when was your first jump and what kind of drove you to do that?
My first jump was in 2003 and it was right here. I had no desire to skydive. I just had friends that were skydivers and never thought about it one way or another. And can't even say after the first time I had the drive to even do it again.
Wow.
But then I found out you could learn how to do it on your own, and that kind of perked my interest. After I did that, as years went by, it became my lifestyle, my culture. This is what I've been doing. I've been in the healthcare industry for 15 years, quit everything, and been doing this full time.
That's incredible.
For a long time now.
That is so great. My next question. So for somebody that wants to skydive by themselves,
okay,
how long is the process? What all goes into it in order to be certified to skydive by yourself?
Well, again, I'm one of those types of instructors too. We have an AFF program. So first thing would be you'd get here at 8 o'clock. Same thing, you would fill out the waiver,
mm-hmm.
and then you would go through the first jump course, which is about 6 hours long, give or take, just depending on the student. After you do that, you will actually go on your first jump with two instructors. We hold on either side of you, help you get your body position, make sure that you're paying attention to your altitude and doing the things that we need you to do to jump on your own safely. After that, you continue on. As you go to your next jump, we give you some more objectives to follow. You pass them, and by your third jump, we let you go. And if everything goes right, you land safe and sound on the ground. Once your parachute opens, you're all on your own. We have a radio and we'll be telling you right turn,
yeah.
90 degrees, left 90 degree turn, or something along those lines. And we kind of train you every step of the way for everything you need to do on your own.
Wow.
Yeah, so it just depends. People can go through it as quick as they want to, and other people take the time. It's just everybody's different.
Very nice. I like that.
Yes.
That's definitely informative. The last question, kind of a two-parter and a little bit of a bet that her and I have going. You've seen the movie Top Gun?
Yes. Of course.
Of course. So when you think of the movie Top Gun, what is the first song that comes to mind?
Oh, Danger Zone.
Thank you. Yes, Danger Zone by Kenny Loggins.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Bevo, thank you so much.
It was my pleasure. Thank you guys for joining us, and hopefully we'll see you again.
Oh, absolutely will. If you're in the Southern California area, or even stopping through,
yes.
Skydive Taft, they will take great care of you. They took great care of us. I was a nervous wreck beforehand. I've had the time of my life.
You can follow us at Skydive Taft. We also have our Instagram up there. And then you can also follow us on Facebook.
Are you ready for your interview, Mr. Dan?
I'm
the
so
man!
Ready.
Dan the man!
Dan the man!
He was my instructor and he was incredible!
Thank you.
He matched my energy, which is so hard to do. I'm very impressed, I must say. Can I ask you a couple questions?
Sure.
All right, so first question. When did you start skydiving and what made you want to be a skydive instructor versus doing it for yourself?
I started skydiving in 2009. And just wasn't, it was a hobby at first.
Okay.
Right? Everybody starts out just a hobby.
Yeah.
And some of us just need a little extra in life.
Yeah.
And it's been amazing to me. It's given back to me.
Okay.
So much. And just being able to take someone for the first time, I get to relive my first experience every
single
time I jump with you guys. So it was really fun.
I love that. Second question is, I noticed you all packing your own parachute.
Mm-hmm.
So how long does that usually take for you all to do? And is it like a strenuous process?
You get used to it. You learn how to be efficient. It takes me about 8 minutes to pack the parachute.
Wow, that's awesome. Yeah. It's a good chunk of time though to do that.
Yeah, it's a good bit. Your first one will be an hour. Your first time
wow, packing. Really? An hour? That's incredible. Well, that's good that you get it more and more and better and better each time. My last question is a fun one. So, Austin and I have a little bet going. You've seen Top Gun, I assume.
Yes.
Okay, when you think of the movie Top Gun, what song do you think of? Not that everyone thinks of, which one do you think of? What's your,
It's The Danger Zone.
Damn it. Fine. Austin wins. I think of you've lost that loving feeling in the bar.
Oh,
you
know. Okay.
Appreciate you, Dan. I really do.
Thank you for the jump.
Of course. Thank you. Everyone, Dan the man and Skydive.
Dan the man.
Awesome. Thank you.
And now for an adventure recap.
Wow! I cannot believe we did that.
The more I look back on it, the more I'm like, I continue to question, like, how did we do that?
Well, for me, it's more so like, wow, we really did do that.
It's unbelievable.
Like, it feels like such a distant memory already because it was so quick, I feel like.
Yeah.
You know? Like, in the moment, I always, like, as people have been asking me about this, I've been telling them, like, in the moment, it felt like a good solid 30 minutes that it lasted.
That's true.
I was really present in most of it, that I was able to enjoy and take it in so much. But once, like, as soon as I hit the ground and got down, I was like, God, that was like 5 seconds. I was like, it immediately felt so quick. I don't know why.
When you're free falling and when you're up there in the parachute, it definitely feels a lot longer than it actually is.
It felt.
But it's because, it really is because you're living in every moment. You're taking in the surroundings.
It depends on who you are, though. I bet you if you ask some people, they're like, oh, no, it goes too quickly. Like, I, like, blacked out almost, you know?
Yeah, literally, like, blacked out and then I was on the ground.
But for me, I was having so much fun while doing it that I was, I was living in every moment for sure.
Yeah.
Is that how it was for you then?
During the free fall, I was definitely more focused on myself. Only because, like, because you're falling so quickly. So, I forget how much. It's like 120 miles an hour.
Oh, it was so fast.
and the pressure of it, of you falling. Like, I had to continue to remind myself to breathe.
Also, I just want to stop you there. Sorry to interrupt. I hope I'm not the only one who was laughing at that video, at Austin's footage. When he was like, I don't know why he was. I'm always like, Austin, why are you like this? It stayed there the whole time. Go back and watch the video. It's so funny. He just like throws it up and it does not leave. Like he doesn't like do this. It stays there the whole time. It's hilarious. He was like so fierce through the whole thing. I loved it.
So the reason that I was like that the whole time is because when we were first dropping, I had my mouth open. And I realized very quickly that number one, my mouth got really dry, and also it was like the feeling of like when you like you are in the wind and you open your mouth and it's like doing that thing, and my mouth started doing that, so I closed my mouth.
I don't remember that part. I don't know what it was like.
It's just because your face was locked in a smile the whole time. You're just like,
oh, maybe. Yeah, I was having the time of my life. Like, kept saying, I'm flying. Like, it really did feel like you were flying. And I've always wanted to fly, really, like a bird. And it really does put you in that perspective. And it's just, the whole thing was beautiful.
It really was an incredible
You could tell. Yeah, you could tell. The only part that I got really nervous was when I started to get vertigo a little bit. Like, I looked down, I was like, this looks like a green screen. And then it was like this. I was like, oh, this isn't a green screen. I was like, okay. And that's when I was like,
I do have to say, so that was one of the worst parts for me, specifically, was when you are free-falling and, like, are on the parachute, you're going to have the time of your life.
That was my favorite part.
The most incredible experience. It is so liberating, but the anticipation and the lead-up to that.
The good thing is like, as long as you did not say no, you didn't want to go, they weren't going to stop you. They did it the only way, and they did everything. Like, I've heard so many people say that you had to fall out. That's not the case at all. You just stand there, at least at this business. Yeah. at this place.
You stand there and they're
and they do they it. Do they it. Do everything. So as long as you're not like, I don't want to, they won't like stop it.
Yeah,
they'll just
and obviously
do it.
And
I loved that.
Yeah, I credit our instructors so much because
Dan the Man
and Bevo.
Yeah,
were both amazing.
Incredible.
If it came down to like me saying like I don't want to do this, then Bevo, and I applaud him. He was so understanding. He took such good care of me. And if it came down to like me not wanting to do it, he was totally understanding. Yeah. And they're all very understanding.
They are.
If you don't feel comfortable doing it, they're not going to make you do it.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
They'll bring you back down to the ground. They'll make sure that you're all right. You'll get a full refund. Like. They want to make sure that if you're going to do it, that you feel comfortable doing it.
Did they give you a full refund?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. That's awesome.
Yep.
The only thing I'd say that was a bummer was that we went on a day, first of all, it was so hot, but...
Unbelievably hot. Don't go in the summer. That is what I have...
Go whenever you want, but
okay,
it is going to be hot.
Don't go during the
in
heat
California,
of the day
yeah.
on a summer day.
With, like, obviously in the open desert, but I expected when we got there that the guy would be there. They say that there's a videographer that goes with you and does like a swim movement towards you.
Yeah, a solo jumper that does...
all the video footage, so they don't have to do the selfie thing, which was also really great footage and worth it completely. But we showed up and that guy wasn't there that day. So if you want that footage for sure, which we were bummed about, but we got such great footage that how could we even be mad? Do not reserve your day until you ask what day they will be there. Because sometimes he just won't be there.
Absolutely.
So
make sure you
thing.
Call ahead of time. Be like, when's the videographer going to be there? Because I really want to get this footage. Like,
right.
I want to share it with my family, share it on my social media.
This type of footage. Exactly.
Yeah.
But,
it worked out for us. I think that the angles that we got were just absolutely spectacular.
I also want to say that... before I forget the thought, I want to say that they had a foosball table there that helped me think, like, get Austin's anxiety down about it a little bit. And that was super nice that they had that in the lobby for you to kind of relax with.
There's a nice little lounge area. They have a foosball table. It definitely helps a lot, especially if you're like me, where my anxiety was going haywire, absolutely haywire beforehand.
And during.
On the
plane
ride up.
Because the foosball game helped you, like, relax.
Yeah.
Once you were in the plane, immediately just spiked again.
Yeah.
Which naturally, of course.
It was bad. And I have no problem admitting that. I had a full-blown panic attack.
Your fingers went numb.
Yeah, I had a full-blown panic attack on the plane ride up.
And I asked him that night. I asked you. I was like, what got you to do it? I had no idea if you were going to do it or not.
Yeah. It came down to... I was the last person out of the plane.
Mm-hmm.
Well, me and Bevo were the last people out of the plane.
Mm-hmm.
And
except
for,
of course, the person driving it. No pilot.
Wow. And
all right, bye.
Marissa went right before I did. And when I saw her go and Bevo scooted us up to the door, it was, you can see in the video, like you see me take a deep breath where it was just like, this is it. Like, this is my last opportunity to either... you know, say no, I don't want to do this, or do it. And then I kind of thought about it and told myself, like, if you don't do it now, you're never going to.
After we got back, I asked also, I was like, I had no idea whether or not you were going to do it. And I asked him, I said, so what made you go through with it? Like, what made you in that last moment be like, all right, I'm going. And he said, well, as soon as I saw you jump out of the plane, I was like, well, you gotta follow her. He was like, I saw you go, and I was like, all right, well, it's settled. You're going. And I was just
That's
like,
it.
Aw, I loved it.
That is actually still true. It was like I had so much going through my head up to that point, heading up to the door. And it was quite funny because everybody beforehand, like Dan was telling me, Bevo told me, they were like, you will have, if you have bad anxiety in general, you'll be, you know, a wreck on the way up. The moment that you get out that door and you're in free fall, you're not thinking about anything else.
And I was so proud of him once he landed and he was like, we're absolutely going to do that again and again and again. I was like, you said that. And I was like, that's amazing. And I was so proud of you.
I was the type of person because before that, I still kind of do. Deathly fear of heights.
Okay.
I hate heights. But I was the type of person that never thought I could really go skydiving. It was one of those things where like, oh yeah, I want to go skydiving.
Right.
But like, I don't think prior to, yeah, I never thought that I'd actually go through with it. And the fact that I did, I'm so, so happy and so proud that we were able to both experience that together.
It was an amazing adventure, and I can't wait to do it so many times with you.
Absolutely.
It was wonderful. And it's so worth it. Just
it really is.
Rip it off like a VM date if you want to do it, because the best things in this world to do as an adventure are the things that are going to be the things that we fear the most, you know?
It's
pushing
true.
The limits. And like we always say in every video, if you step outside of your comfort zone, you can experience something so remarkable that's worth it. So.
Absolutely.
So which part of the entire experience was your favorite? The favorite memory of the whole experience.
The favorite memory? I'd have to probably say the one that I at least revisit the most is, one of the things that her and I do for like a mode of meditation and workout is we do Kinergy.
Mm-hmm, the best.
And for me, when you're doing Kinergy and go through the elements, earth, water, fire, and then last that you do is air.
Mm-hmm.
When I'm in like the mode of air and like I'm thinking about air, the number one thing I always revisit is how it felt like free falling and just being in that and looking around and seeing everything. And every time it just takes my breath away again. It's just,
that's funny. My favorite part is the free fall.
Yeah.
And that is the shortest part of the entire thing. Yeah, that was our favorite.
I was gonna say, you're only free falling for, I think, 30 seconds.
I was taking that part. That was the most amazing part to me, the most earth connected part, because here I am, a human being who has no ability to flap wings and fly at all, yet I'm falling and the wind from earth is with resistance holding me up from hitting the ground so far until you need to. But I'm saying it doesn't feel like you're falling. It doesn't at all. It will not, because that wind is so powerful that it's resisting your body and feels like you're actually just floating.
That is actually really an accurate description.
Yeah.
So if you're the type to like not enjoy roller coasters or, you know, like drop towers,
mm-hmm.
where that is like a very real sense, like you feel like you're falling.
Right.
Skydiving is not that. And I was really, really surprised. And now that I actually think about it, it kind of took me aback. During free fall, it didn't feel like I was falling.
No, it didn't. Not for me, at least.
Yeah, it feels almost like you're floating.
Yeah, it was wonderful in so many ways.
Yeah.
In fact, weekends after 4th of July, Austin and I went to a roller coaster ride, and we did a roller coaster ride that we were like, that was worse than skydiving.
By far, a much more intense experience than skydiving.
You never know. This is why you just gotta try things and then see how you like them. And then if you know you don't want to do it again, it's off the list.
Yeah, and if you are like me, I still very much encourage you, do it. Try it. I still hold it in the highest regard. It was by far the most liberating experience that I've had in my life. I've never felt more alive, more free than after I did that.
Good. Thank you guys so much for joining us again for this adventure.
Hope you enjoyed the video.
Absolutely.
If you did, like, share, become a member of our community, and then spread the word so we can spread the love around the world.
How you join our community is you either follow us and like us on Facebook at Where the Wanderers, or
subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Or join us on Instagram as a follower, and we join and connect that way as well. So please join us in this wonderful travel and adventure community of loving our Earth. We're the Wanderers, signing off. We'll get it. I got it.